Hey folks, today I got a real treat to show you. This is something we recently acquired in the shop, and it's a brand that we've actually never had here before, and so I'm not real familiar with it. It is from Dobro, and this is the Dobro Deluxe Round Neck, and it is a classic resonator. You can see there the resonator in the body of the guitar. Now again, this is something that we've never had in the shop before, so I'm not real familiar with it, but if you're watching this and you own one of these or you know a lot more about it, feel free to chime in the comments below. So this video is really gonna be more some close-up views to give you an idea of what this looks like and how it's put together and such. So we'll start here up at the neck. It looks pretty traditional here. It's got a matte finish on the headstock up there, and then traditional tuners there. Look very similar to what you'd find on a Martin guitar. And then it's got a little plaque right there. All right, then kind of going down a traditional neck you can see there. Nothing too out of the ordinary until you really start getting down to the body, and that's where this one really stands out and looks quite a bit different with that large resonator. And I'm gonna try to go closer so you can see in through the different slots on the resonator. And I don't know if this is coming through on the video, but even as I'm talking, it's projecting into the resonator on the guitar and making noise here. So really a pretty neat, intricate design looking in there. And you can see where the strings go down and they actually cross through where the saddle and the bridge are down there. Very interesting design. Like I said, we've never had one of these in the shop before, but it looks to be very well made. Let me pull out again so you can see the face. And I'm not entirely sure of the different specs, the different species of wood on this guitar, but it looks absolutely beautiful. And this one's got also a matte finish on the body, and then a real simple black binding going around to the sides there. So very nice, very simple. I think really in this case, the resonator is really what stands out on this guitar. You know, it's not real ornate. The details are pretty simple otherwise. And then you also notice it does have three little holes drilled out as well. But yeah, I can just hear myself as I'm talking and projecting. I can hear it resonating right out of here. So I can only imagine how nice it must sound when you put this in the hands of someone who can play it and is familiar with it. I'll give you some shots of the back there. So really nice the way they've paired these up. These appear to be a little bit different. So I'm not sure if they were back-to-back slices from the same piece or maybe similar ones, because they don't really line up so well, but it kind of gives it character the way they did that. But everything's very tight. You know, I'm looking along these joints here where the binding is, and even here in the middle where the seam is, and everything's very tight and snugged up. I don't see any cracks or any kind of workmanship defects. So I would say, just based on some other guitars we've had in here in the shop, that they've done a really good job putting this all together. The manufacturing up looks really good. And you can see there the joint right at the heel there. Nice and tight, looks very clean. A little bit of lacquer maybe, or whatever they used to finish that kind of piled up a little bit in there, but otherwise it looks really good. And then I'll give you a look going up the back of the neck there as well. And of course you got your classic Grover tuners, that's why it looks a lot like a Martin. And then the serial number. So they kind of looks like they, it's not really a stamp, it's kind of like a label or something that must get printed over the lacquer when they finish up there. And I'll just pull out so you can kind of get a wide view of this particular guitar. Really neat. Take it off the stand so we can get some other shots of it here. And again, just kind of looking into the resonator. Really intricate design. Very neat. It'd be interesting to take all that off. It's just got some Phillips head screws going around it and really get an idea of what that looks like inside. It appears that these are just grills. I can see in, it looks pretty hollow. I can see kind of the inside along the binding inside. It looks very traditional as far as how they've secured that together. Can't really see anything else as far as any other bracing inside. So I'm not really sure how that's put together there. But I'll spin it around just to give you some more close-up views. And again, if you own this guitar or you know more about it, definitely chime in and let us know in the comments below. I think it'd be really helpful to the community. But really beautiful species of wood that they used on the sides and the top. It appears to be all the same type there. Really interesting guitar though, so I hope these close-up views help. For those who aren't familiar with J Brokers, we are a risk-free secondhand marketplace and we buy and sell all kinds of items. A lot of times it's gadgets, but we also do things like this guitar here and all kinds of collectibles, cameras, things like that. But basically, if you're looking to sell something, definitely check us out. We're risk-free, and so we're a great alternative to eBay or Facebook Marketplace, where you don't have to worry about all the scams and shady people that are out there. We basically take care of all those details for you and pay you a lump sum of cash, and that's what our customers love about our service. So definitely check us out online at jaybrokers.com. That's jaybrokers.com.